Hey everybody, this is Sean from Sean of All Trades, and today I'm going to be showing you how to install a vinyl plank floor.
Here are the tools you will need to install your vinyl planking floor. Knee pads, a sledgehammer, a tapping block, and a wide angle pole bar. Spacer wedges, a utility knife, beer. You will need this after 6 to 8 hours on your knees. You may need more than one.
Step one, calculate how much vinyl planking you're going to need. When you're buying planking and subflooring, add 10% to the amount you actually need. You're going to wind up needing it. When you get it in your house, let it acclimate in the room it's going to go in for 48 hours. Moving on. Step two, prepare the subfloor. If there's any kind of dips, if there's any high spots, you got to sand them down. If there's any low spots, you have to fill them in. If there's any nails coming up, pound them in. If you have a squeaky floor, this is a great time to sink some screws into the joists and make sure the floor doesn't squeak anymore. You'll be amazed what you find underneath your carpet. It's really disgusting. But when it's cleaned up and it's nice and pretty, then you're ready to lay down the underlayment. Step three, underlayment. This is the underlayment product we're using. It is a thin polypropylene foam. It has sticky tape on one side, and it has this plastic moisture barrier on the other side. I'll show you how they interact when we put it down. This is essential. It's this very thin stuff, but it acts as a moisture barrier, it acts as a sound muffler, and it gives you a nice clean surface to lay your vinyl planking down on. So let's unroll this and see how it fills the room. Okay, I'm about to start laying down the underlayment for the dining room. Here's the first of your decisions. You have to decide which way your planks are going to go. My planks are going to go this way, so I'm going to lay my underlayment this way. That stuff likes to curl up. So, once I figure out where it's going to go, I like to take a plank, put it on the land, hold all the way up to the edge. If there's a little excess, that's okay. You can cut it. Better too much than not enough. And once you've got it where you want to go, reach around to the other side, pull the tape, stick it down. This tape sticks really well to itself and really well to the moisture barrier, but not really well to old subfloor. So if you want to, you can get some double-sided carpet tape and put it underneath here. Once you start laying the floor down, this stuff isn't going anywhere. So it's really just to keep it down while you're working. Now that I have one piece down, I'm going to pull the moisture barrier out from one side. So you just unfold. You get about 2.5 inches out of one side. So you go down the entire line and unfold the moisture barrier. Now that it's in place, I'm going to take my plank, push it up against the wall, and cut the excess off. Just that simple. So now I'm starting my second piece. This tape seals very nicely to this pink moisture barrier. So this one's going to go down even easier.
Move me!
Time to start laying planks. This is where it gets fun and really rewarding. Before you start laying planks down in the room, you want to measure the room. These planks are 6 inches wide. So if you have a room that is 15 foot even, 14 foot six, perfect. Start laying with a full board and go to town. If you have a room like mine that's like 9 foot two, you do not want to start with a full plank. Because what you're going to do is you're going to get to the other side of the room. That last plank is going to be this tiny little 2-inch wide thing that's just a real pain to cut and handle and yuck. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by ripping a board so it's 3 inches wide, cut a board in half, use that one to start, and then go from there so I don't wind up with any ridiculous small plank. Killer Ant, come here and show the people. Come here. It's very important that you have a small dog. What a small dog can do for you is keep you grounded. If you spend too much time on your knees, he can take you out for a walk, and you can watch him pee and bark at other dogs, and he can get your tools and move stuff around, hide stuff. So the most important piece of equipment besides your knee pads is a small dog. Here's how you cut a piece of planking. This stuff does not need to be cut all the way through. You don't need a saw. You don't really even need that many muscles. What you do need is a nice, sharp utility knife, and you need a board that you have no intention of putting anywhere on the floor. That's why there's one nice piece of blue tape on it. This is my cutting board. I use this as a template, and this is the most important board I have. So I decided I want to make the boards 3 inches. I'm going to measure down 3 inches from the no fin side and make a little mark with a nice sharp pencil. Now we're going to take our extra plank, line that up on the 3-inch mark and make sure it's straight. Now, like I said, you're not cutting all the way through this stuff, you're just scoring it. Take your nice sharp utility blade, don't press down with all your might, because where you score it is where it's going to snap. Take it easy. I'd rather you score it 4 times lightly than twice hard. I'm barely even pushing. All you gotta do is break the seal here. That'll do it. It's nice and scored, so then start on one end and just break it. And kind of go up, back and up, back and up. Look at that. Now, this is the piece with the short little fin, not gonna use it. This is the piece with the long fin. It's now 3 inches long. Also, this edge that I cut and scored is not perfect, but that doesn't matter. When you put this stuff against the wall, you leave a 6 millimeter gap all the way around, and you're gonna cover the edge where it connects with quarter round molding. So nasty edges that aren't perfect is no problem whatsoever, which is great. Before we get to the main event, I want to show you how these planks go together so you don't have to learn by making mistakes the same way I did. You want to fit your small lip in first, slide it up as high as it'll go, and then you tilt the entire plank up and slot it into the one above it. You're going to wind up a little bit of gap right here. That's okay. Make sure there's no gap here. To fix the gap, take your tapping block, put it up against the lower one on the lip, not on the fin. You do this on the fin, you're going to break it. No more gap. If this piece is up against a wall, you want to use your wide angle pull bar. Put the wide part on the lip, and then you hammer this way. Simple. Here's how you lay your first row in. Take your starting piece. If you're going right to left, the sides with the longer fins, this side goes to the right, this side faces down, or I guess out into the room. So here's the first piece. First piece just sits there. We're going to take some of these little wedges. So, one goes there, one goes here, one goes here. Now, as you start, since there's nothing holding this thing in, these are gonna fall all over the place. So, I'm actually not even gonna worry about letting those stay up until I start getting some more pieces in. So, here's my first connected piece. This edge has the little baby short fin. This edge has the longer fin. So I'm gonna stick the short fin down into the longer fin. Make sure the edges are lined up. Make sure there's no sunlight in there. There. Now you can see, I don't know if you can tell, the way I cut it, this edge isn't perfect, not exactly the same, but that's okay. It's getting butted up against the wall, it's gonna get quarter round on over it. Nobody's gonna ever know the difference. Now we're on to full boards. This is where we start flying. Full board. Baby fin, big fin, big fin. If you take nothing else away from this video, take this away. I wish someone had told me this. You gotta put the little end in first. Down and in. Make sure there's no gap. Get it as butted up as you can. Now this little baby fin here on top is gonna have to go up and under, so it's gonna take a bit of finagling. So we get this guy in there as close as it'll go. Now, we travel down to the other end, lift it up and in. You can hear it click into place. We've come to the end of the row. How do we accurately cut that little baby piece that goes in there? Well, here's how. You get yourself a full board. Lay the board that you want to fit in that gap directly over the preceding board. Make sure it's nice and lined up. Make sure it's directly over. Now, take your little extra template board, don't want the tape on it. Make sure it's going the right way. And butt it up in there. It lays over the board that wants to fit there. And now, by cutting along this edge, this is the piece you're gonna end up using. The reason you do it this way is you wanna retain the baby fin edge because it's gonna fit in there. So, this is the bit you need. Get rid of you. Now, this piece doesn't have a baby fin edge anymore, which means it likes to live on this side of the wall. It'll start our next row. And meanwhile, this guy, put the short edge in first, put it up, up and in, you go, lovely. As you can see, I had to cut my quarter round at some pretty funny angles to fit it into the angles of this room, but once you're finished, you just cover those up with joint compound and no one will ever know the difference. And here we have a finished dining room. It looks really nice. The vinyl planking's gorgeous. I put quarter round all the way around the outside of the room to hide the gaps. We have a small dog, so everything is as it should be. All you gotta do is sweep it up, move your furniture back in, and you're finished. So, there you have it. I installed about 1,100 square feet of vinyl planking in 11 days. It was a lot of work, but I probably saved myself about $2,500 to $3,500 worth of labor. So, if you've got the back, you've got the knees, I highly recommend you install your own vinyl planking. It's a beautiful result, and it was actually kind of fun taking on a big project like this. This is Sean of All Trades, and we'll see you next time I do something big around the house.